So to the left here is the entrance for Mutumbi Cemetery. RIP to all the departed, I guess. The people that have gone on to the other side, the only people that know what's on the other side, if at all there's anything. Mutumbi Cemetery and Remembrance Park. Alright, depressing place. I want to get as far away as possible from this place. Let's go back home. Yeah, I think that it's a bad idea to cycle. I've been sick these last few days. Ah. We're still attempting the reverse Jaeger loop today. Dust. What? they fixed this here. Oh, sharp corner here, blind spot.
kupanga dawa.
Thank you. was on the road. Here. Quite sure where Zambezi road extension starts. Should be here, I think. I need to have this thing realigned or something, because it's See if we can push this. I'm sick today, so I'm taking it easy here. Why? God, the pond. This is one of the reasons I wouldn't want to stay anywhere close to this place. Is a number of small-scale farmers, right? Count yourself lucky. You can't experience the stench coming from across, right? A mesh of chicken poop and cow dung, I think. Couple goals, I believe. Mauka. Look, mom, no hands. As if she would care. Oh. As does this. Whew. I wonder what's happening down there. Hello. Como? I wonder whose idea it was to put up this pedestrian bridge here. Probably the area member of parliament. As someone decided to sink a well here. Not sure if you could see that, but... Right. What? Would you look at that? I didn't know there was a Ngwerere section. Station. All right. I wonder if the train stops around here. Mauka. Mokabond. You may be near about a train. Oh, I'm putting up a sanga sanga. I'm going to go to see my media. You might be there in 30 minutes. You might be there how many minutes, pa? Oh. So you have to go. Oh, okay. Huh. Where are you going? I'm going to go to Monza. Oh. You're going to go to the bus, huh?
Yeah,
that's the same. So you're going to go to the bus? Okay, siko mkwambili. Miende bwino kumonze. Yeah. Alright. No idea the train stops there. Whoa. I hope I didn't puncture my tire there. And I'm wondering if it's coming in the opposite direction. Or is it... I've lost my bearing here. I'm not quite sure where Monza is. But, doesn't look like it's well aligned here, but fix it later. Bum, bum. Be careful here. as does this now, I feel much better. I can attempt to accelerate a little here. Yeah, Mauka. I think I still have a bit of time to cut across and pass through Kudu village. Let's see if we can do that. Hello. In case you're one of those people who's not very familiar with this part of the city, so I'm cycling through District Road, and to my left, where you have this makeshift blue fence, if you will, or enclosure, is a housing development that's just popping up. And by the way, to my right is Papa Joe's. I've never been in here, but it appears to be one of those popular hangout places or something in the south. But so Emerald Hill is one of those upcoming housing developments. I believe it's meant to sit on a total of about 56 hectares of land, I think. I'm not sure if I'm mixing it up with with something else, but it's supposed to sit on 56 hectares of land, and they plan to build a total of about 690 units. So these units they come in various sizes. The size that I still remember is what they call a T2, I think. This is meant to sit on a 20 by 30 lot, I believe. So yeah, in case you're wondering how I know about all of this, they came through to my workplace and did a presentation. Turns out that if one decides to have a house built via their union, they get to pay a discounted price, if you will, which is a pretty good deal, I guess. Emerald Hill. I'm not quite sure about the place. I mean, I cycle through here almost every week, and I don't know, there's just something about District Road that I don't quite like. For starters, I mean, it's sandwiched in between farms. I've never been a big fan of dog poop and chicken poop, you know, the stench that comes from chicken poop or cow dung. So yeah, I think all of this should be part of Emerald Hill, I believe. I think they're the ones that paved this road also. I'll have to check maps to see exactly where this road leads to. I wouldn't be surprised if it takes you all the way into maybe Airport Road or something, I don't know.
All right.
Those of you that are familiar, if you are familiar with a housing development, a much smaller housing development called Silverest Gardens, I think this place is modeled on that, right? So you have the option to slowly pay off the house of your choice, I guess. So I am going to cut across Kudu village here. Kudu village is that is it. But Kudu village is yet another housing development. I think Galunia Farms it is behind it or something, could be wrong. What I quite like about some of these you know, housing developments that are popping up is there's usually a bit of kind of like attention paid to, you know, them making sure that the place is serviced, obviously, and so you're assured that you're going to have access to electricity, right? So no need to struggle and, you know, lodging your individual independent application through to ZESCO, because all this is done for you. And more importantly, the roads, right? I have no idea how important all these things are. Or you don't have an idea how important all these things are up until you go to a place like Minudwamwen or something. I pity the people that live in that area. So, this thing here. Yeah. I think I still have a bit of time. Yeah, so I believe all of this is Kudu village. It takes you all the way into Nali Road. So you actually get off, or you get out of Kudu Road somewhere near Mutumbi Cemetery. This housing development actually shares a border with the cemetery, I believe. Unfortunately, I've forgotten the average prices for buying land in Kudu village. I'll have to look this up or something. I'll probably type it in the description box of this video if I don't forget. Talk of roads, yeah? Not exactly the type of... I need to have this thing serviced. I think the last time I cycled through here must have been 2000 and 2008, I think I did a video of Kudu Village. That was way before people actually started constructing houses in here. Last time I was here, which was, is it last week or the week before, I noticed, should be a week before actually, I noticed that quite a number of people had actually started constructing houses in here. I'm not quite sure what's on my left here, but it looks like one of those restricted areas, and I think it's owned by Zambia Airport Corporation or something. Yeah. I need to have this thing fixed, yeah? Horrible stretch of road. I was actually planning to come through here with a very dear friend of mine who seems to be knowledgeable when it comes to building or constructing houses in Lusaka. So I'm interested in picking his brains in regards to what his thoughts would be about this place, right? Location and the price, I guess. Oh, there you go. You can literally see that there's a little bit of work being done on the road here. They're trying. Not as hard as we would want them to, but they're trying nonetheless. Yes, yeah. Shoot. So you may not appreciate how bad the road is because the bike I'm using today has a rear shock, so vibrations are not really as nasty as they would be if I was using a different bike like the Ascent, for instance. The road is bad, that's what I'm trying to say here. Some kind of battery power here. Here with this yellow truck, the Yellow King. Yeah, Malun. Yeah. Goodness, I'm starving. It's a good thing I have leftovers from last night. Thank you. Not quite sure what's going on up ahead this other road here, but that's the second track I'm seeing using that road. The wind goes right. There's somebody's building construction next here. Building here. Let's check out what's on the right here. See what sort of progress people are making. I'm almost running out of battery power here, but that's okay. Let's try and accelerate a little here. Beautiful. Go! Kudu road, progress! Look, mom, no hands! Straight. Hey, somebody just cleared this lot here in preparation to start boating. Probably drew inspiration from the neighbor on the right there. Yeah, I'm out. No problem. There we go. There we go. So this right there, up ahead, is the entrance. The entrance for the so-called Kudu village housing development, right? This place I'm just from cycling through. It starts from right here. I'm not quite sure how far it stretches on my left here. What I do know though is it's quite a few kilometers. There we go. So it appears I was cycling through Chimpampa Road. Well, I'm not sure if you can see here. Oh goodness, this looks like phase one then of Kudu Village. Beautiful stuff. Beautiful stuff. Chimpampa Road. Okay. Kudu.village, kudu.village at lovetheland.co.zm. Alright. So I believe overlooking me here is, I think it should be part of Mitumbi Cemetery or something. Should be wrong, but I think it is. So to the left here is the entrance for Mutumbi Cemetery. RIP to all the departed, I guess. The people that have gone on to the other side, the only people that know what's on the other side, if at all there's anything. Mutumbi Cemetery and Remembrance Park. Alright. Depressing place. I want to get as far away as possible from this place. Let's go back home. Very sad place. I suppose what makes it depressing is knowing that a couple years from now I personally will be there, right? Well, probably not buried in Mutumbi Cemetery, but I will die.